round, round, get around.
I get around.
Yeah,
get around, round, round. I get around.
I get around. Where the kids are hip. My buddies and me, you're getting real well known. Yeah, the bad guys know us and they leave us alone.
Lately it seems like Zach is taking this program way more seriously than usual. Maybe it has something to do with the fact that the superintendent's coming or something. So I mean, for God's sake, he's making us dress up all fancy in these stupid, ugly clothes, and I...
Stopping by for a visit. We just need to make sure that the situation with Bryce screaming at the kid doesn't get brought up. If that doesn't get brought up, everything will be fine. Just perfect. Nothing will go wrong. Just fine. Alright, you guys made sure that Johnny's not here today? We need to make this place as appealing as possible.
Don't worry. Told him his dog died.
Nice!
Mason, you still looking as adorable as ever?
You bet, Zach!
Excellent.
Like I said before, Zach's becoming extremely uptight with this program. And I have four words for that. I don't like. No, wait, crap.
I give the ginger a lot of credit. I mean, it takes a lot of manpower to lead a teacher's aid program where all we do is play murder mystery games and go to each other's houses. Why is the superintendent even bothering to come here?
Oh my god, you guys, I just drew a picture of a hamburger beating the crap out of a puppy. Bryce, you gotta see this, man, you gotta see this.
No!
Go on, dude. Just look at it.
Dylan! No! Just let me do my work.
Mason, there are some papers in the copying room that require the force of two men to be copied. Not the force of three men, so Bryce will not be taking along in this journey, because the force of three men would be too much. And if I were to go solo, or for say you were to go solo, it would not be enough force to get the papers printed. So, you and I will journey to the copying room. We will copy those papers. We will not discuss Bryce. Bryce will not even be along with us. It will only be us two, as three people would be too much for us. So we will go into those and get those papers, and we will not discuss Bryce whatsoever. We will get the papers, come back, and resume our lives. You understand?
What the heck is wrong with you?
So, what are the papers us muscular men need to take care of?
There are no papers, my young Mason. but instead the deal of a lifetime. Come on, Mason. God, not now. All right, fine. What papers? Here, here. Jeez. Happy now?
Yeah!
Okie dokie, well, we're gonna prank Bryce. Well, come on, dude, it'd be funny. I mean, he's always pranking Johnny, and even if he wouldn't be a good sport about it, it'd be pretty funny to see him freak out, you know?
I think that'd be a very moronic idea.
Zach, seriously?
What the heck?
Alright, here are the copies you need, so now me and Mason are gonna go off and prank Bryce.
I still don't think.
Yeah, whatever.
Zachary Dickhut?
Sir, I think you may have missed the turn to Joseph A. Banks.
I'm the superintendent. So, shall we begin the interview?
Sounds good.
Alrighty then. First question! Is your staff generally enthused about the end of the day?
Alright, gentlemen. It's closing time. Most of the time. Not really.
Well, I know I would be, if I had a ginger for a boss.
Being a ginger doesn't cost anything. Unlike a program at Weight Watchers.
Yes, 11:42 a.m., the exact time of day Bryce always goes to use the restroom. Perfect time to pull a prank. All right, Mason, go get as many cups of water as you can and fill them up to the brim with water.
Tell me about your staff.
The staff? Well, there's Mason.
Hey, Bryce, you stupid!
Mason, could you make a few copies of this script?
Fischer sounds like something else. So tell me about this Johnny Marthaler fellow.
Pass.
What?
Okay, this is a pretty pointless prank. Oh, no!
Let's hear about this Brink Virginie guy.
Bryce Verhan? Obviously, your college degree speaks for itself. Yes, he's a toughie to explain.
So basically what you're telling me is that he's perfectly calm and normal 1 minute, and then he's...
Some weird demonic creature the next, absolutely.
If this is what our generation consists of now, I'm truly concerned for our next generation, especially with that ginger teaching them.
It's strange. All this time, I thought the obesity epidemic was fake.
So tell me a little bit about this last guy, Dylan Fischer. He's the one who made the remarks about Joseph A. Bank when I first came in here. Which, by the way, fantastic store.
Yes, if you consider Joseph A. Bank's the used suit section at Goodwill. And yes, he is the one. Actually, he's the newest member to join our program. Believe it or not, he's not always like that. I can remember the first day we met. You shouldn't be in here.
Okay, that's just why I need Ginger to sneak up on me while I'm trying to work.
Well, that's a pretty mean way to start off the conversation.
You're the one who snuck up on me.
Hey, I didn't even know there'd be another person here. Besides, it's a Saturday afternoon. What are you even doing?
I'm doing work.
I see. Do you enjoy doing work?
Sure.
Would you be interested in joining a little club, so to speak?
I'm really not interested in joining your hair color cult.
Wow, you really have no bounds on what comes out of your mouth, do you?
Nope.
Well, would you be interested in joining this teacher's aid program for this pod?
No.
Oh, come on. You'd get to come in on Saturdays and work for the teachers so that they're prepared on Monday.
Wow, yo, that just sounds so amazing. That just completely changes everything.
I can interpret sarcasm.
Well, I'm glad you do, because that would have been very awkward having to explain it to you. So, without further ado, I'm going to excuse myself to the library so I can actually get some work done.
I could just pick each staple out with my hands.
And those big meaty paws of yours would make the water in the cup overflow.
Alright guys, just help me get these out of here.
I dare say I already know the answer to this question, but I'll ask anyway. Do you guys normally accomplish a lot when you come into the office?
What, Dylan?
Die!
Oh.
official. Mason sucks at being a chicken. It literally smells like butt cheeks in here.
Never did really realize what the smell was. I suppose we just had to find a tolerance for the smell of rotten butt cheeks.
Hey, Bryce, why don't you try using the Force? Get it? He likes that stupid Star Wars junk.
Don't you ever make fun of Star Wars! Got it? Now both of you are gonna help me get these cups out!
Do we help out the teachers and give them some slack, but we've created so many good memories and we've all become friends in the process.
Well, I'm very lighthearted and I do not regret to inform you that you can no longer be part of this program. Zachary Dickhut, you had to see this coming. One of your staff members literally called a child and began trash-talking him over the phone.
I
really don't take pleasure in this. I know you're a good guy, and you've done a fairly good job with the program excluding that phone call.
Then why are you doing this?
I was supposed to let you go first thing when I arrived here. But I wanted to keep this program alive, so I had to ask questions before doing it.
How long do I have?
Honestly, the sooner you pack up your things and leave, the better. Sorry, Zach. But you're fired.
Leave it up to your staff to decide who the next leader will be. I'm sorry it's had to come down to this, but something needed to be done. Hopefully the next person who steps up to the plate won't be a ginger. And, of course, keep the program alive.
Can I help you?
So this is where you guys all work, huh?
Yes, sir.
Where is everyone else? I thought you said there are other people working here with you.
Oh yeah, there are, but this is Saturday afternoon. It's usually just me working here. I come here often.
That doesn't really seem right.
Hey, I don't mind. It is Saturday. Most people have plans. Once in a while, I don't even come in here to work.
Well, if I was in the crew, I'd be in here working every Saturday.
What are you trying to say?
I'd like to join the Fond de Cures.
Welcome aboard. I wish you were a stranger, I could disengage. Just When Dylan first joined, he showed up every Saturday like he first promised. I'm gonna miss this program. I'm sure the guys will do just fine without me, though. I have faith in them. But you know, getting fired isn't really that bad. I mean...
discard as I lose the arguments in a cable car hanging above as
Zach just got fired? Who does a superintendent think he is? He can't just come in here and take our heart and soul away like that.
It's ridiculous. Really? Zach was the only one out of all of us who understood what was going on.
What's even gonna happen now?
How are we even gonna find a new leader?
You know what? I declare myself the new leader. I mean, I used to not even know what the heck he's doing. Bryce is the cause of all this, and Johnny, well, he's never even here.
Out of the remaining people, I'm really the only one who's qualified to lead us.
I have more swag than all three of those other guys combined.
I mean, sure, I may have lost control when I yelled at that kid, but that was months ago.
You know, it's almost like Bryce is intentionally trying to destroy the program. Well, you know what? I'm not gonna let that happen, because I'm gonna...
kick their butts and show them who's boss!
So they better all watch out, because...
things are about to get
real ugly.
Over my head, over my hip, 8 seconds left in overtime. She's on your mind, she's on your...